Hello and welcome back to Amulya's Academy YouTube channel. We were discussing BFS algorithm. Today, let's see how to use BFS algorithm to find whether given directed graph is a strongly connected graph or a weakly connected graph. A directed graph is said to be strongly connected if every vertex is reachable from every other vertex. A directed graph is said to be weakly connected if it is not strongly connected graph. But if we consider it as undirected graph, then it is connected. So here we have example. This is a strongly connected graph. You can reach any node from any node of this graph. For example, if I want to reach D from A, here there is a path. But this is a weakly connected graph because you can't reach A from D. Right? This is a weakly connected graph. Today we want to write a Python program to check whether given directed graph is a strongly connected or weakly connected. How to do that? In the previous tutorial, we wrote a Python program to check whether given graph is a connected or disconnected graph using BFS algorithm. Let's use same method here today to find out whether given directed graph is strongly connected or weakly connected. And let's see whether it works or not. This is the program which we wrote in the previous tutorial. And here, this program is written for undirected graph. Here we used this method. I'll give the link of the video in the description box. Okay. Let me copy this part of code. And here we have our program which is written for directed graphs. Here you can say add node, add edge, and BFS function. Next, here we have a graph. Okay, this is a directed graph. Then we have here graph, print graph, and BFS function call. After that, what I'll do, I'll paste this code here, right? So here what we are doing is, first we'll call the BFS function, we'll traverse the given graph using BFS function. Next, what we'll do is, we'll check for every node of the graph. We'll take the node of the graph one by one using this for loop, and we'll check that node is visited or not. If it is not visited, then that given graph is a disconnected graph. After executing, after traversing a graph using BFS algorithm, if any nodes are not visited, that means that is a disconnected graph. If all the nodes are visited, then that graph is a connected graph, right? So we used this method to check whether given graph is a connected or disconnected graph using BFS algorithm. So today we are using the same method. What we'll do is, first we'll call the BFS function. After that, we'll take every node of the graph one by one using this for loop. Next, we'll check whether that node is not visited. So we'll use this method, if I not in visited one. After executing BFS function, all the visited nodes will be in this visited one set. So we'll check if I not in visited one. If it is not, then I'll take it as not a disconnected graph. It is a weakly connected graph. Okay. So if any nodes of the graphs are not visited after traversing the graph using BFS algorithm, I'll take that graph as a weakly connected graph. If not, if all the nodes are present in the visited one set, then I'll take that graph as a strongly connected graph. So let's see whether this method works or not. So I'll save this. Here starting node is A. So output here is given graph is a strongly connected graph. Fine. Next, what I'll do is, here I just change the starting node to D. Just change the starting node and save and execute. Here we can see the output, given graph is a weakly connected graph. For a single graph, we are getting two different outputs when I change the starting node. So that means this method is not working. Actually, this graph is a weakly connected graph. If I start the traversal operation from the starting node A, you can reach every other nodes of the graph. But if I start the traversal operation from D, you can't reach many other nodes, right? That's why it is a weakly connected graph. But here in our program, this is actually not working. Here for weakly connected graph, this piece of code works. Here if any nodes are not visited, then that is a weakly connected graph. But for strongly connected graph, if every nodes of the graphs are visited, that doesn't mean that it is a strongly connected graph. If we can reach every node of the graph from a certain node, that doesn't mean that it is a strongly connected graph. So we need to change that logic. So let's see how to find whether the given directed graph is a strongly connected or weakly connected graph using BFS algorithm. So what we need to do is, the first step, we need to run BFS algorithm on the given graph. After visiting all the nodes or after completing the traversal operation, in the visited set, you'll get all the visited nodes. Now you can check, pick all the nodes of the graph one by one, take one by one and see whether that node is visited or not. If any nodes are not visited, that means that is a weakly connected graph. It is done. There are two possibilities. One, all the nodes of the graphs are visited, or a node is not visited, right? If a node is not visited, then that means that is a weakly connected graph. No need to check for any other nodes. But if all the nodes are visited, then what we need to do is go for the next step. That is, you need to reverse the direction of all the edges present in the graph. So here, this is our graph. You need to change the direction of all the edges like this. Then call it as a graph 1, another graph. Now what you need to do is, you need to apply BFS algorithm on this graph. Now again call BFS algorithm, keep the same starting node, okay? After traversing this graph, we'll get two outcomes. One, a node is not visited. So then that means that is a weakly connected graph. If all the nodes are visited here also, then it is a strongly connected graph. If there is a path from starting node to every other nodes of the graph, then there should be a path from every other node to starting node. If this is true, then that is a strongly connected graph. First, run BFS. If every nodes are visited, then there is a directed path from starting node to every other node. Next, reverse the direction of all the edges in the graph. Run BFS again. If all the nodes are not visited, then that is a weakly connected graph. If all the nodes are visited, then that is a strongly connected graph. So let's write the program. First, we need to run the BFS algorithm. Take any starting node. Next, let's take every node of the graph and we'll see whether that nodes are visited or not. If any node is not in visited one, it is not visited, then that graph is a weakly connected graph. Okay, one step is done. Break, execute break, come out of the loop, stop the execution. If not, if every nodes are in the visited set, if every nodes of the graphs are visited, then we need to come to this else part. Else block will execute only when this loop is not terminated by this break statement. In the else block, what we need to do is, we need to reverse all the edges of the graph, right? So for that, what we need to do is, we need to take another graph. This is the graph where all the edges are reversed. Direction of all the edges are reversed. Okay. This is actual graph. Then let's take another visited set. Okay. Now done. Next, what we need to do is, when we add node, we need to add that node to graph 1 also. We are creating another graph here. Graph 1 is nothing but the graph where all the direction of the edges are reversed. To reverse that edges, you need to take graph of V2, append V1. By this, we can reverse the direction of edges. Next, what we need to do is, we need to call BFS function on that graph 1. Take same starting node, that is D, and here graph 1 and visited T. Take another set to store the visited nodes here. Next, what we need to check is, if all the nodes are visited, that means if visited and visited T, this both are same, if it is equal, then that is a strongly connected graph. If all the nodes are present in both the visited sets, then that is a strongly connected graph. So visited 1 is equal to, it is a strongly connected graph. Else, both are not equal, then that is a weakly connected graph. Just copy this. Okay, so what we are doing here, first we'll call the BFS function, we'll traverse the given graph. Then we'll check whether all the nodes are visited or not. Here, if it is not visited, then that is a weakly connected graph. Stop the execution. We know that that is a weakly connected graph. If not, if all the nodes are visited, here we can't conclude that that is a strongly connected graph. For that, what we need to do is we need to again call BFS function on the graph where direction of all the edges are reversed. After calling this DFS function, we need to compare both the visited sets. If both the visited set contains all the visited nodes, then that is a strongly connected graph. If not, it is a weakly connected graph. Let's save this and execute this. So given graph is a weakly connected graph. If I change starting node here, A, and here also A, and again run this, then also we'll get same output. It is a weakly connected graph, right? Next, let's change the graph. Here you can see. So let's execute this. So here we can see it is a strongly connected graph. Okay, so this is about this program. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.